everyone, welcome to Botany Insider. So let's continue the topic that we were discussing in the previous video itself. In the previous video, we discussed about the neomycin cassette in detail. It is one of the topics from the unit 13, that is methods in biology. So in this lecture, we would be discussing about the CRE LOXP system in detail with previous year question practice also. So let us just quickly revise what we have discussed in the previous lecture. So in the previous lecture, we discussed about that gene insertion means the gene knock-in, and knock-in can also be called as cloning, and cloning could either be cell-based or the cell-free cloning. In the case of cell-based, we have the PCR system, about which we would be discussing when we would be dealing with this topic in detail. Talking about the gene deletion or the gene removal, which is called as the gene knockout. So in knockout, we majorly have two main systems. The first one is the neomycin cassette, about which we have discussed in complete detail in the previous video. If you have not watched the previous video, please do watch it also. And in this lecture, we would be focusing upon the second aspect of the gene knockout, that is the CRE LOXP system. So first of all, let us discuss about that what is CRE LOXP recombination, or what is this system all about. So CRE LOXP recombination, it is a site specific recombinase technology that is used to carry out deletions, insertions, translocations and the inversions at specific sites in the DNA of the cell. So in simple words, we could say that it is a type of technology in which what we are actually doing is we are either deleting, inserting, translocating or inverting the DNAs at specific sites of the cell. It allows the DNA modifications to be targeted to a specific cell type or be triggered at a specific external stimulus. In simple words, what we are doing is we are trying to do some kind of modification in the DNA as by the help of these four processes, either one of them is used, and as a result of the usage of these methods, what we are actually analyzing is we are actually at the end result, we are modifying the DNA. CRE LOXP recombination involves the targeting of a specific sequence of DNA and splicing it with the help of an enzyme that is called as CRE recombinase. The CRE LOX system is used as a genetic tool to control the site-specific recombination events in the genomic DNA. Make sure you remember about the terms like the site-specific recombination, the first thing. Second, it is used as a genetic tool, the second thing. Next, specific sequences are targeted, and also there occurs splicing of the DNA sequences. How it occurs, we'll understand in the subsequent slides. So, talking about the CRE first. In the CRE LOXP system, we have two components, CRE and then we have the LOXP. Talking about the CRE, so CRE recombinase is a tyrosine recombinase isolated from the bacteriophage P1 that catalyzes the cleavage and the ligation of the DNA at specific nucleotide recognition sites, the LOXP site. The site that is targeted upon is given the name of LOXP, and it occurs via the phosphoryl transfer. Make sure you remember about this complete sentence, because it is one of a potential statement from part B and part C, both type of questions. It is widely used tool in the field of molecular biology. The enzyme's unique and specific recombination system is exploited to manipulate the genes and the chromosomes in the huge range of research, such as gene knockout or gene knock-in. This is what we are actually focusing upon, that is, we are using the CRE LOXP system in the recombination, or we are using it in the gene knockout strategy. Talking about the LOXP, the second component in the CRE LOXP system, CRE is a recombinase and LOXP it is a site, and there occurs arrangement, and that arrangement is mostly specific in nature. It is about 34 kilo base pairs in size, and they are always two in number. That is, when we analyze a gene, so in a gene always two LOXP site would be present. There occurs three kind of variations. The first one is the deletion, then we have inversion, and the third one is translocation. What are the various symbols of each of them? Let us discuss about it. So in case of inversion, now what we have to remember is that CRE LOXP system, this complete system works upon the arrangement specificity. That is, the way in which the LOXP sites are arranged in that particular manner, the CRE recombinase enzyme could actually work. First one is inversion, then we have deletion, and the third one is the translocation. Each one of them are dependent upon the site, or they are dependent upon the arrangement of the sites. For example, in case of inversions, we have these arrows. These arrows actually depict the LOXP site. And what is LOXP? We have just discussed that these are the sites which are always two in number and their arrangement specific. So when the LOXP sites are facing towards each other, in that case the gene between these two sites would get inverted. It gets in opposite manner. You can see in this that there are two LOXP sites, and in between we have gene X, and as a result of this arrangement, what happens is that the CRE recombinase comes, and finally what happens is there occurs the inversion of this gene X. The gene X got inverted in the product, and these arrows, these blue arrows, represents the LOXP site in all of these arrangements. Talking about the second one, in which we have the deletions, so what happens is that when the arrows are in the same order, they are in the same line of order, what happens is, as a result of being in the same line of order, the gene X gets deleted, or there occurs deletion of the gene X by the help of the CRE recombinase. And as a result of the final product of this type of arrangement, there occurs deletion, and the gene X between the two LOXP site gets removed from the gene. In case of the translocation, what happens is that the LOXP site is present in two opposite strands of the gene, and as a result of it, there occurs translocation. As you can see, in the initial case, we have the red and the blue arrows. And when the CRE actually works, the CRE recombinase has performed the work between these two LOXP sites, there occurs a combination of red and the blue ones in both of the strands. So this is the case of translocation. Make sure you remember about these arrangements, why questions are framed from this area only. Let's just quickly recall it once again. The first one is inversion, in which the arrows or the LOXP site are facing towards each other. In the deletions, the arrows or the LOXP site are in continuous manner, and in translocation, the LOXP site are at the opposite strands. They are situated at opposite strands. In case of inversion, the CRE recombinase comes and inverts the gene. In case of deletion, because of the specific arrangement, the CRE gets the stimulus of deleting the gene. And in case of translocation, because of this specific arrangements, the CRE comes and translocates the parts of the strands to the opposite strands. So this was all that we need to remember, or that we need to focus upon in the CRE LOXP system. Let us try to solve two questions from the previous years. The first question, it is a part C question, and it says that in the following diagrams, segments A and segment C are the copies of 10 base pair repeats DNA sequences flanking a unique stretch known as B. A and C are in the inverted orientation as indicated by the arrows. Intramolecular recombination between A and C leads to this event. So what we have to do is that what would be the actual result of this particular type of arrangement. So you can see that A and C represents the LOXP site. You can compare these boxes with these arrows as we have discussed or as we have learned it depending upon these arrows. So because these arrows are facing towards each other, what would be the final result? So as we have discussed that when the arrows are facing towards each other, the gene in between gets inverted. So this is what we have to find the correct answer. So you can see option one says that the complete region encompassing A to C will be inverted, which is an incorrect statement because the LOXP site does not get inverted. Second says that only A and B will be inverted. No, this is also an incorrect statement. The third one says that the only B will be inverted, which is a correct statement. Why? Because of the specific arrangement, because of this arrangement in which the two LOXP sites are facing each other, the CRA recombinase would get the stimulus of inverting the gene in between, and as a result the gene B would get inverted. The D option says that only region A and C will be inverted, which is also an incorrect statement. So with this we have the correct option as the option C. You can see this question is very easy and you can easily fetch out 4 marks from this question. All you need to remember is the specific arrangement sites for the various CRE LOXP system and you are good to go for these types of questions. So with this, we are done with the complete topic of gene knockout in detail in 2 videos. In the first video, we dealt with the neomycin resistance and in the second video, we discussed about the CRE LOXP system. So I hope these 2 videos were helpful for you. So if you like this video, please do like, share it with your friends and please subscribe to my channel. And also, I'll be coming up very soon with more informative videos as well. So thank you so much for watching and I'll see you soon. Bye.